A land of innocence has no need for gods. Until fate intervenes.
Keep away from the water!
Stop!
When people pray, a god is always born.
Help! Someone help us!
Help our child!
We call to the heavens!
Able to change eternity. That god is you. Are you a blessing or a curse? Good or evil? Be what you will, you are destiny.
You've saved our boy! Thank you! Thank you for your mercy!
We praise you!
Greetings, we're your conscience.
Good
and evil.
Yin and yang.
Black and white, as part of you, will guide you through this world.
Hey, what's up, guys? I would like to pause this small intro scene to give you some info about the game. So my name is Daddy Cool, and you are watching Black and White Good God playthrough. And the reason for this Good God playthrough is that my last time I played this game is roughly 15 years ago, and at that time I played more or less evil god, and I thought it's high time to play on a different approach, and I decided to play or try to play as a good god in this playthrough. So let's continue this basic learning curve that we will be witnessing in a couple of minutes, and after that I will give you more info.
Our people will want to worship you. Please come with us to our village.
I'll show you how to follow them. How to move? Let's see. You move your hand in the direction you want to travel, like this. Then you click and hold the move button. After that, you move the mouse towards you to drag forwards or push away to move backwards. You click, hold, and pull again to cover more ground. Follow your new worshippers to the village. You'll have to grab the landscape several times.
So, what I did before starting this playthrough, I have set a couple of things in the options menu, and for example, I can move with the keyboard buttons like this.
We're in this direction!
So I do not need to grab the ground like this. I can move freely, I can change angle of the camera, which is not possible yet, but you will see a little bit later. So these are very important things to set in the
Your
game.
Your arrival was foretold! The prophecy has come true! We can now finish the temple!
Let's move to the temple by clicking and dragging, or double-click the move button on it to go straight there.
Okay, I just travel here.
Hey, it's not finished!
Well, we could help them complete it.
Yeah, when it's finished, this temple will be the focus of our power.
But now it's time to learn how to look around. You move the hand to the side of the screen until the rotate arrow appears like this. You hold down the move button. Then you move the hand in a circular motion to rotate around and see things from a different angle. You can rotate either way. You can also use the keyboard. Now you try look.
Okay, just as
yes?
I said, I can do this with the keyboard
That's
controls.
It.
Which is much easier.
Good. Now let's learn how to look up and... You move your hand to the top or bottom edge of the screen until the pitch arrow appears. You hold down the move button. Then you move the hand to look up and down. You can also use the key. Now you have a game.
Okay,
that's it.
Same applies for this one.
That's it. You've got the idea. Yep. One last thing. Zooming in and out is very useful. To zoom, you click and hold both the mouse buttons. You move the mouse towards you to zoom out, like this. And you move the mouse away from you to zoom in. Zooming as you can also use the... Now you try. That's it. You've done it. All this moving around is giving me a headache. I think we may need to practice a bit. We can go to the God's Playground by pressing F2 on the keyboard at any... Now we've learned how to move and look, we can help the villagers. Let's take supplies of food. First you move the hand over the food or wood like this. You pick up by pressing the action button. The longer you hold, the more you pick up. You can still drag while holding objects. You press the action button while holding an object to drop it.
So let's pick up maybe, 3,000 pieces of goods. That's roughly gonna be enough till they finish.
Why not help the people finish building the temple first? You can scroll through some of these info signs to read all the text. Hold the action button on the text and move up or down. Any information you read on one of these is added to the library in the temple.
Okay, just because the info from the signs is added to the library and I am more or less familiar with the text and the things that you can do with them, I'm not gonna...
Why not help the people finish building the temple first?
I'm not gonna read them one by one, but if you play with the game, it's strongly suggested to read them through because they help a lot of things on navigation. On
Why not help the people finish building the temple first?
Okay, on gameplay and so on, so they are very useful in general. I think it's ready.
At last, the people have finished our temple.
This is the entrance. Click the action button on it to take you inside.
Incredible! The tribe built all this. And to think, it's a monument to you as a god.
And us as your conscience, don't forget.
The workmanship is amazing.
And what a symbol of overwhelming evil.
No, it isn't. Now look, this here must be a map of the whole land.
What about all these doors?
Each leads to a room. The rooms are extremely useful.
Let's try some.
Okay, so in general, this is the map we are playing in. This is the temple location, the headquarters, I can say. And we have a red circle here. This is the influence area in which we are playing and in which we can create stuff and do things. Outside of the circle, it's pretty limited what you can do, but yeah, the further you go, the less influence you have and the less things you can do in general. Okay, so regarding the temple and the rooms that the good and bad consciousness suggested, we have a save game possibility, a library with information in it, future room is not possible yet to check, options room, this is the place where you can adjust settings for control and camera and so on and so on. We have a creature cave, which is not possible yet because at the moment I do not have a creature yet unlocked, and a challenge room which shows the usually silver scrolls. We will check them in a couple of minutes. Okay, let's continue the things outside.
Now we have a temple, let's explore. I'm dying to know what these signposts are.
No, there's so much we gotta do. I say we hunt out the gold story scrolls. We'll need these if we're gonna progress through this world. A gold story scroll looks like this.
Clicking on gold story scrolls with the action button will lead you through your quest in Eden. You can activate the scroll or you can explore. It's up to you, leader.
Okay, so I'm just gonna click these signs, so I have them in the library, unlocked. I think there is one more in here, yeah. Okay, so basically the game will look something like this. We will have also a creature and we are playing and guiding a village like this with people in it and so on. And to advance the story, there is one possibility. I have to check this golden scroll. This is the main storyline, and we can do side quests. And side quests.
A silver reward scroll. Let's see what it means.
Yeah, silver ones ain't as vital as the gold ones, but we can still check them out.
Okay, so they just interrupted me. So there are silver scrolls, which are not main objective, but side quests, we can say, and you can do them anytime. And I am familiar with this first island already, and there are two quests I can prepare just now. One of them is gonna be here, it's a sheep. We have to collect sheep, which you already, I think, heard. And one of them is staying in here. But I'm gonna collect them here. And the other side quest, which we can do and prepare, is collecting stones to this circle. Like this one. And yeah, we can do it anytime, and I would like to do it before we advance with the main story. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm gonna collect the stones. Yeah, here is one more. Okay.
Oh, look, a silver reward scroll. Let's see what it means.
Okay. Yeah, silver ones ain't as vital as the gold ones, but we can still check them out.
Yeah, this is going to get annoying. I mean, this teaching thing. Here is one more sheep hiding on that place. Let's put him here. And I think there is one more in here. And we have picked this one up. Where else? Okay, we have a stone in here to collect. Let's put it here. Okay, and the reason why I'm doing it, I mean, these quest preparations is, here's one more stone, is that once I unlock the creature, he won't be able to do anything intended, I think, and he will do a lot of stupid things, and this means that I have to take a close attention on him and his activities, and it will be much harder to efficiently concentrate on these two objectives, and so it's easier to collect these things before you unlock the creature. Oh, we have one more ship here. Okay, how many are they? Six. There are 10 in total. Okay, I think I know one more stone, and it's hiding in here. Just as I said, I am a little bit familiarized with this mission. Okay, it's 7 stones. There is one more stone somewhere.
Oh, look, a silver reward scroll. Oh. Let's see what it means.
Yeah, silver ones ain't as vital as the gold ones, but we can still check them out.
Okay, I'm gonna do that silver scroll as well, because this is gonna be annoying. Every time I go near it, it will start this intro.
Okay, let's get our projectile skills up to scratch.
What do you suggest? I presume it involves killing.
No, not at all. I was going to propose,
I know. Let's see if we can hit that pillar over there. It's a test of our godly powers, and nobody gets hurt.
How nice. And I guess we use this everlasting pile of stones.
Hmm, handy that. Move your hand over a rock. Press the action button until the rock is in your hand. Hold down the action button. Put momentum on the throw by moving the hand in the correct direction. Throw the rock by releasing the action button. Try throwing a rock now.
Okay, so...
Oh, now that was close.
No, it was not strong enough.
You're doing well, but you have to knock the rock clean off.
Okay, let's try it once more. Yeah.
You hit it! Marvelous!
Neat, boss! You're really gonna do damage with this skill later.
Ooh, we've been given a chest. I wonder if there's anything in it.
Yeah, click the action button on it to open it.
Okay, and I'm gonna put it just here. Okay, so this mission is finished. We received the reward. And we have a sheep here hiding on that place. So now I have 7. Okay, and that's pretty good, because there is one more hiding behind the gate. One more on top of this mountain, and the last one will be the starting quest starting one. Okay, so now I'm prepared. I'm gonna move forward with the main mission and let's check it out.
Greetings, Holy One. You've activated a gold story scroll. My name is Sable. I am a trainer of creatures. I challenge you to open these gates. Behind them are three wondrous creatures. Every god has a creature. They can grow tall as a mountain and can perform miracles. But you can't open the gate unless you find the three gate stones. Each stone you find must be placed on this platform. The villagers were dancing around a gate stone when you arrived. Once you place this gate stone on the platform, I will tell you of the... Now, retrieve the first gate stone, Holy One.
Here's the stone that people were dancing around. Pick it up by clicking the action button on it.
That was easy.
Excellent! You found a gate stone. You'll need to search for another now. Try looking for a gold story scroll in the village.
Here it is.
Oh, Holy One. I kneel before you. My brother, suffering a fever, has left his sick bed and become lost. He's so weak. I'm frightened he'll die. If you find him and bring him home, I'll give you one of the three gate stones. It's in my house.
Hey, I got a plan. Why don't we trash the house? We can get the gate stone that way.
I heartily object. That's just malicious.
Well, that's kind of the whole point.
The lost brother is in some trees through the pass.
So... just because I'm playing as a good god and try to be as good as I can, I'm gonna save him. And yeah, let's put him here.
There you are! I've been so worried! Thank you for your benevolence. Here is the gate stone.
Okay, put it here. And this is also ready.
Good. You have two of the gate stones, but the third could be a problem. The villagers say the final one was destroyed eons ago. All is not lost, though. The village sculptor can carve a new gate stone for you. You should see him.
Holy One, I hear you're looking for a gate stone. I am a sculptor. If you provide me with the right rock, I'll carve one for you. You'll find the rock I need in the old hermit's quarry. Please. I'm definitely the best sculptor in the village.
That's funny because he's the only sculptor in the village. So basically he's saying the truth. Okay, let's pick
Here's the stone you need!
And give it to him. I have to be careful not to drop it because it destroys a lot of things around him.
Oh, that's excellent. Exactly the right kind of rock to work with. Thank you. Come back later and I'll have it finished.
So the reason why I'm saying that I try to be a good god is because it's very easy to do bad things in the game. Like if you pick up something and position it wrongly or accidentally throw it, it damages or even kills people, and there you go, you are not a good god anymore, and it's much easier to do than you think, so I have to be very careful in many cases. Okay, let's make some good things. If I said I'm a good one, I'm gonna put a little bit of food here for the people, and you can see my goodness or favor has increased to 2 points.
I finished. It's ready to be placed with the others by the gate.
Let's put it here then.
The gate stones are together. Pass through and claim your creature.
Here we go. There's the sheep on the right hand side. We will pick him up after I have chosen a creature.
Look at them. Just look at them. These are miraculous creatures indeed.
They certainly are, but not quite as big as I expected.
Not yet, maybe, but they can become the most powerful creatures in the world.
Now that I'd like to see. We must have one. Which should we choose?
Any. They're all special.
If rather small at the moment.
So basically they are very, very cute. I think the drawers made a good job, and also they have very nice expressions, and you can get attached to them. So regarding my plans, I'm gonna choose the ape for now, I think, because this is the smartest creature, and I strongly suggest if you do a playthrough to take the ape, because he learns much faster than the others, but of course you can choose any of the three, because all of them have their strengths. But I am playing with the extended version of this game, and my plan is to play with the horse, and I can unlock him a little bit later, we will see. So let's take
the ape. Are you sure you want this creature?
We've chosen a creature!
This is your creature's new home. He's small at the moment, but look after him and one day he'll be big and powerful. He isn't comfortable in his new home yet. In fact, he's a little frightened. You can stroke him to reassure him. Click and hold the action button, then move your hand to stroke him. Now stroke him by holding the action button and moving your hand over him gently. Stroking tells him you approve of him, and it makes him happy. Excellent. See how he likes that? He feels much better now. I'll leave you two alone for a while. I'll return later to teach you more.
Yeah. And this is one of the parts that you can easily make wrong. Like, you want to pet him and accidentally you hit him. And that's, yeah, a problem. Here you go. Play with the ball. Good boy, good boy. Let's continue this teaching part.
Your creature is getting hungry. I suggest you find him something to eat. Choose carefully, though. Some things are better for him than others.
Okay, so you would think that an ape or even a horse would eat maybe grain and not fish or animals.
Hey, what about some meat? Pork chops? Ooh, he'd love them.
Of course. So you would think that they prefer grain over fish or meat, but in reality, in this game, for some reasons, even the horse prefers to eat fish and not grain because he gets vomiting from the grain.
Give him food by putting your hand in front of him and then holding the action button.
So the best idea to give him
fish. He seemed to like that.
Try feeding him some more. I'll be back later.
Okay, I'm gonna pet him again. So rewarding is one of the things. You can adjust your creature's behavior with, or punishing if he's doing something wrong. So these are the possibilities for you. Like, I have given him the ball and he already learned how to throw it. And later on we can teach him other
things. There's a silver reward scroll on the beach behind those huge gates.
As well. Okay, so why am at the moment he is stuck in this area before I try to go further. And there is one quest which is unlocked in the meantime, and I'm gonna do this one.
This notion that we quite like to sail the ocean, so we're building a big boat to leave here for good. We're not keen on sinking, so we're all sitting here thinking, cause we built it too big and we've run out of wood. Idle, idly, we simply can't leave till we get some more wood. Sinking, so that's why we're sitting thinking, cause we simply can't leave till we get some more wood.
How dare they leave after all we've done for them?
What have we done for them exactly? Perhaps we should help them out. It might be nice.
Okay, so they require wood. And we have in the storehouse some wood, not some, a lot of wood. Okay, here's the bowl, and it has demolished a couple of things there, but not a big problem just yet.
Thank you for this wood.
Okay. They are building fast.
Oh, the boat is now finished, but there's still something on the wish list to keep us all going through the wind and the rain. There's no food on the table, and we can't sail unless we're able, so we ain't going nowhere till we get some grain. Idle, 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 we simply can't leave until we get some grain. There's no food on the table, and we can't sail unless we're able, so we ain't going nowhere till we get some grain.
Okay, so I'm gonna put the ball back, because if he has it, he can play with it. I'm gonna take the food as well and fulfill their request. Maybe 1,000 pieces will be enough.
We're grateful for the grain, Holy One.
Complaining, but there's still one more thing remaining, cause bread is quite boring if that's all you eat. We need some flavor, so do us all a little favor, cause we ain't going nowhere till we get some meat. Idle, idle, we simply can't leave until we got some meat. So do us a favor, find something with a little flavor, cause we're going nowhere till we get some meat.
Okay, and in this time, any of the meat fits, so I'm gonna take a horse and here.
Thanks for all this meat. We need more meat, though.
Yep. Two horses are in.
Thanks for all this meat. Thank you, Highness. We won't forget you, you know.
We have a DiCaprio on the front. It's funny.
Oh, I just hate goodbyes. I just hate good. This pedestal is a miracle dispenser. It charges up and generates one-shot miracles. Click on the signpost for more info.
Yeah, and this is the reason why it's a good idea to make this mission, because you receive water miracles. I'm gonna collect them here, which you can cast for rain anytime, basically, and you can also teach the creature to cast it. So let's go forward with the creature teaching.
Your creature already has his own personality. But you can alter and shape it by... Hey! What's going on? Aye! Punish your creature to stop him doing things like that. Now, slap him by moving your hand quickly from side to side across him.
Bad boy. Bad boy.
Hold down the action button over the creature to zoom in on him. Thanks. He won't try that again in a hurry. I'll come back soon to explain more about your wondrous, slightly headstrong beast.
Okay, so you can reward him and punish him, and with these actions he will learn a couple of things. It's a good idea not to use 100% reward and 100% punish in each time, because then he cannot distinguish between actions. So 10, 20 or 30% is just enough for most of the things. And if you really do not want to make him something, then of course you can go to 100%, like eating villagers. It's not a good, if you wanna make a good behavior creature, then you should teach him never ever eat a villager if he has done it once. And that's one of the things I will teach him first. Okay, I'm gonna collect the waters here, just in case.
Hey!
It's time to take him for a walk. This is the leash of learning. Please click on it, and I'll show you how to use it. Good. Now, click on your creature. Now you've got some direct control of the little beast. You can pull the creature about with the leash. You see that tree over there? Try pulling your creature towards it. Click the action button on the ground to hurry him up.
Okay, let's go.
Yes. Yes. You got it. Very well done.
Excellent. Well done. Did you know that you can use a leash to make your creature interact with objects? Try getting him to pick up that cow over there. Move your hand with the leash over the cow. Then click the action button.
Okay, go there. Pick him up.
Well done. You see, the leash is very useful. Why not take him for a walk? It'll do him good. You can drop the leash by shaking your hand left and right quickly.
Okay, and actually this is a good thing. I mean, picking up things, because this makes him stronger. So it's one of the things that you can teach him. I'm gonna put this stone into smaller pieces. Now you can pick it up. Okay. Put it there. Yeah, and I'm gonna pet him. You have done it good. Okay, let's come here. He's also hungry. I'm gonna feed him a little bit. There you go. Oh, I know. I have something else in mind. Let's go further with the story.
There's more to learn about leashes. I didn't tell you that you can attach the leash to objects. Try leashing the creature to this tree. With the leash attached to your hand, move it over the tree. Double-click the action button to attach the leash. Good. The leash is very useful. Your creature is tied to the tree now. He'll interact with whatever he's leashed to as well. If you click on a leash when the creature's attached to something, you can adjust its length. There are two other leashes for you here. This is the leash of aggression. It encourages your creature to get angry. This is the fluffy leash of compassion. It makes your creature behave nicely. Why not experiment with these leashes? They're powerful tools. I'll bid you farewell. You now know as much about creatures as I do. One thing remains. Legends tell of an ancient creature somewhere on this land. I've heard him, but I've never seen him. He hides from us humans, but he has great knowledge, I think.
There are advanced techniques for using the leash. Find them on this signpost.
Okay. So, this is the point where I think I can change my creature. teacher. Okay, yeah. And the possibility to do so is here at this hut. So I'm gonna take my creature here, attach him here, and let him run to this position. And yeah, he's on the way. Good boy. And in the meantime, I'm gonna make the sheep quest.
By the great gods, I've been asleep. I was just counting my sheep when I dozed off. Please find my strange sheep.
Just as I said, on top of the hill. And one is already
well,
in the
Well, they were gonna be slaughtered anyway. I say we waste the wandering mutton.
But if we find and return them, we'll have a dyed-in-the-wool follower.
Well, the saintly one made a joke.
Okay, so we have two there. Oops.
Many thanks, higher power. Keep them coming, please.
Oh. Creature is exhausted and teleported back to the temple. Let's come and feed him, because I think he is low on strength. Why cannot I pick up the... Hey, what you doing? This is not good. Bad boy, he has just eaten a villager. Never ever eat a villager. So let's try it once more. Run here, please. And I'm gonna continue with that mission. Yeah, I hope he will get there. So, the sheep. Here we go. Free.
Many thanks, higher power. Keep them coming, please.
Four. There is one more in here.
Many thanks, higher power. Keep them coming, please.
That's five.
Thank you. Looks like you've returned my flock. I can't offer much, but take this with my thanks. We've got some food!
Okay. The creature is running further. We are okay. And... sheep number 6, 7.
Oh, you found another sheep. I forgot there was more than 5. Good gracious, another
9.
Sheep. Superb work.
Creature,
you found another sheep.
Almost there in the meantime. And that's 10 sheep.
Oh, all my sheep are back. Thank you. Behold, a sheep! You may use him as your creature.
No way. Too scary. I'm not gonna use him for sure.
Swap your creature with this one if you want.
No, I have a better idea. Come, come, come. You have to come here.
Look, I have these wondrous creatures you can choose from.
And I'm gonna take the horse.
Are you sure you want a new creature? Click the action button on the creature you want to swap to.
Yep. Both of them are very cute, but I never played with the horse character, so this time I want to try it out.
Great, boss! If you want your old creature back, just return here later.
Okay, and I'm gonna take him to this tree. Okay, and come here. This will take some time for him, but he's a little bit faster than the ape, a little bit stronger, but on the other hand, not that clever. But okay, let's check this scroll.
Holy one! There's a huge creature in the valley beyond! We're all terrified!
This must be the creature that Sable spoke of. Let's investigate.
Okay, I need the creature for him.
Look
I
at
think.
The size of that! Ah, okay, we're dead. We're all dead. What is it? Where's it from?
It doesn't seem to be aggressive, though. If it is, we're all dead. Even the spirits, dead! You told us!
Can you hear that? This giant is communicating. It's telepathic.
You have a creature. Bring him to me.
No way! He'll eat him!
But this giant looks friendly. Let's bring our creature over with the leash.
Please, use the leash to bring your creature to me.
Okay, I will soon.
Swap your creature with this one if you want.
Not swapping. Okay, the horse is running to the place I wanted to take him. For this quest we need the creature, but this one does not require anything.
Hi man, neat stone circle, huh? It's a bummer that some are missing.
Sounds like we can help there.
What? Help this deluded sack of burnt out neurons?
The stones have to play a scale. That's what we need. Tap a stone to hear its note.
That's a false sound. It's not good. Okay. That's also a false one. Maybe this, like, oops, not good. Okay, I think I'm ready. I just have to wait once more.
These are the right stones, but they're in the wrong order.
The stones have to play a scale.
What's the problem? Okay, I have it. Change them like this. Come on. now.
Wow! Now this is a good vibe! Amazing!
Something is happening. The stones are singing together again.
Another of those cool miracle dispensers.
Okay, let the dispenser work. And I wanna check my creature because he's here. Yeah. I want you to go to sleep. Because it's night. And he's growing in the night. So he should be coming here and have a nap, sleep a bit. Come on, that's it, good boy. He regains energy, he regains strength. That's the proper place to be at this time. In the meantime, I'm gonna grab the food miracle and collect it to here. Okay, he's still sleeping. So from this point on, I have to take a close eye on the creature because he can make really stupid things. And I do not want him to learn things that I do not want him to do. Okay, come here, I mean stay there and sleep. Okay, I think I'm looking at you because you were sleeping here, but that's okay. I'm gonna give you some fish, which I can, I mean I can. Okay, sleep, or I need to eat. Okay, and it's already morning, come on. We gonna do this mission.
What's all the fuss?
A freak wave has just struck. My husband and four others are drowning. Please help them.
Well, let's see. Who do we know who's tall enough to wade out to them?
Don't muck around. Let's get our creature out there as fast as possible.
Yeah, so come on. We gonna take them out. And put it on the shore. Okay, let's take the next one. On to the shore. Okay, next one. Great. Also to the shore. Okay, let's take him as well. Onto the shore. And the last one as well, I think. There you go. Put him down. Wonderful.
Oh, I'm so grateful. We'll get some extra worshiping done.
Well, yeah, you're grateful now. Nice. Another of those cool miracle dispensers.
Okay, let's pet him. He made a good job. Okay. So, I think roughly this is the end of the first episode, guys. Thank you for watching. And yeah, I'm gonna save the game now, and we will continue from this point. See you next time.